Hello, dear students. So now today we would move ahead in this first chapter of class 10th history, that is the rise of nationalism in Europe, where we were discussing some findings of the French Revolution. Some points we have discussed in the previous video. Some other points are there in the French Revolution. So these are some points. The first one is Jacobin clubs were established. These were the places where the liberal movements and the liberal ideas were flowing, because similarly, if you see, these Jacobin clubs were established in different areas of the Europe. Okay, so if you see, these were the places where the ideas of means a kind of they were the friends of the people who are just there in the Jacobin clubs. They are just friends of the constitution. Okay, they are just friends of the freedom also. Okay, means they are promoting the liberal ideas, kind of. Okay, they are just flowing a liberal movement, you can say. Okay, so the liberal movement and liberal ideas were flowing in these Jacobin clubs. So these clubs were established there during the time of the French Revolution, when it was there. So in different areas of the Europe, it was established. Okay, now we are going to see some developments, because it can be asked in the questions or examinations also. The good and bad points about the Napoleon. Okay, what were the developments under the Napoleon? Because if you see, there earlier there was monarchy in France, then later it became democratic, then later again the Napoleonic era came, it became hostile again. Okay, so these kind of development you would see in France there, isn't it? So when the Napoleon came, so there were some development under the Napoleon also. Like, he brought this civil code in 1804. This code is also known as the Napoleonic code. So here he means many good things he had means he just discussed there. Okay, like, he did away with the privileges based on birth, because the France was divided in the different kind of category of the people there. Okay, so the people who are living in the higher category, so the child who are taking birth in the higher category would be having more rights than the child who are taking in the lower category, birth in the lower category. Okay, so means the child were having the privileges on the basis of the birth. So this was abolished there, because all are same now. Means he was kind of promoting the equality there, isn't it? So he did away in this civil code in 1804, he did away with the privileges based on birth. Okay, in the civil code there, he just means one more development was there, like weight and measure system, which we have already discussed in the previous one. Weight and measure system means unified, you can say. Okay, your weight and measure system he brought there. That also a good point there. Okay, and you can say the language also. Okay, France also has become one language. And you can say about the currency also, there were more than 20 currencies there in France. Okay, but later they were reduced then. Okay, so these are some developments under the Napoleon. Like, established equality, he established equality there, because like we have just now said, the privileges on the basis of birth, that he abolished. Okay, so it means he was trying to establish the equality there, isn't it? Next one, he secured the right to property also, because who is living somewhere, so he would be having the right of that one property, isn't it? Yes. Next one, he abolished feudal system also. Feudal system means, let's say you have a landlord, and the landlord is having this much land, and now in this now in feudal system means you have the worker here known as the farmer now. Okay, so these workers would be working on this land. This land is not of this farmer, this land is of the landlord. Okay, now this farmer are paying loyalty to the landlord, because they are working on his field. These farmers are working on the field of the landlord, so for this they are paying loyalty to the landlord. So this is known as the feudal system. Okay, this is known as what? Feudal system means it's a kind of political system where you have the landlords and the tenants. Tenants means those who are working on the land there of the landlord. Okay, and in return, in exchange, means the tenants has to pay the loyalty to the landlord. So this is the feudal system. So that was there existing in France. So Napoleon abolished this. It means he was again trying to establish the equality. Yes or not? Because these tenants are working there, and they are working also, and they are paying loyalty to the landlord also, because they are working on their land. Getting it or not? So he just abolished this feudal system. So it means he just freed these farmers from the serfdom. Serfdom means because they were kind of doing means work there and paying loyalty. So there was means kind of serfdom was there, isn't it? So he just freed these farmers from the serfdom. Okay, because serfdom means they are the workers of this one landlord, isn't it? So he just abolished this. It means he freed these farmers from the serfdom, isn't it? So these are some good points about the Napoleon. And one more thing, that he improved the transportation also. The transportation system throughout the country, he has improved it. So these are some good points about the Napoleon. Okay, now some bad points are also there. Initially the development under the Napoleon were good. Later he became hostile. We can say that as initially the French armies were welcomed in the Brussels because he was trying to just expand his empire. Means this is the France. So now the Napoleon were trying to expand the empire. So he sent his armies to other part of the Europe there, like in the Brussels, in the Belgium, like Milan, Italy, then Warsaw. So Warsaw it is, okay? Warsaw. So these are the some places where he sent his armies. So his armies were welcomed in these places because he were just kind of promoting the liberal ideas, yes or not? So here in these places we have the Jacobin clubs also. These Jacobin clubs were also promoting the liberal ideas. So Napoleon was also doing the good work. That is why the French armies were welcomed in these countries. But later the French armies also became hostile there. They tried to now increase the taxation. They increase the taxation, and the forced conscription is also there. Forced conscription means every member from a family. Forced conscription means just it's a kind of every member of a family should be there in army. Means where everyone should be there in the army. Means you are forcing someone to serve in the army, isn't it? Suppose someone do not want to join the army, but you are forcing. The condition is that every member should each family should be there in the army. Okay, so it's a kind of forced conscription. So these are some bad things about the Napoleon, which were not welcome. And later on, these countries where he was trying to expand the empire, these countries also were against the Napoleon then, and they tried to stop the Napoleon again. Okay, so this led to the downfall of the Napoleon later, isn't it? So we would be discussing some more about this French Revolution later in the upcoming lecture. So before this, you note it down. Okay, till then, stay tuned and keep watching. Thank you. Have a good day.